Welcome to the Hank Cisco Show. Don't touch that remote. Got a great show here today. This is going to be a little bit about boxing. You're going to meet a guy that's really been involved in boxing, promoting, not only promoting, but he used to be a boxer, you know, like myself, you know. The time comes when you do so many things. You're a boxer, you're a promoter, you know, and all that together. And you write a book, you know. So that's what we're going to talk about. Yeah, and so here's a guy that he bobbed and weaved, you know, and he's a great friend of mine, and I'll tell you a little how we got together and some of the good things we put together. So, my friend, and in this corner, weighing 100 and Damon Feldman.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Thanks, Hank.
Damon, thank you for coming on the show. You know, you've been around a long time. You've met a lot of celebrities, and you've been in California, Vegas, and all. So, and you're a Philadelphia guy, right? Who's your manager?
My dad.
Oh, your dad. Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah, did my own thing. And, you know, I wrote my book, and it just talks about my life as my mom getting injured in an accident, quadriplegic in a wheelchair, me and my brother living with three different families. My dad raised me, got into boxing, changed my life around.
Well, he was a boxer, too?
My brother?
Your dad.
Yeah, he was a fighter. He won 23-2. Then he ended up being a boxing trainer.
I wonder if I ever refereed any of his fights.
I don't think you did. A couple of his fighters, Augie Pantelis.
Yeah, Augie Pantelis. Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen pictures of him.
Yeah, and okay. So in boxing, did you fight in the Golden Gloves or what was it? Diamond Belt? That's what I fought.
Yeah, no, I fought in the Junior Olympics. I won this Pennsylvania Junior Olympic Championships.
Oh, yeah, I know.
But then I turned professional, and I stopped at 9-0 because I got injured in an accident outside the ring.
Oh. Yeah. Now, what are some of the places where you boxed? Now, there was a Cambria?
I fought at the Blue Horizon 8 times and the Civic Center once, yeah.
And where else?
Civic Center.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, Civic Center once.
Yeah, they used to have fights there every 2 weeks or so. Then the Philadelphia Arena on a Monday, and then the Thursday was the one on Broad something there.
Yeah, I forget the name of it.
But. Yeah, it's on Broad Street, named Broad something, whatever. But there was a lot of fight, the Cambria down in the
Kensington. Yeah, I'm very familiar. I'm a boxing historian also, so.
Yeah. Not much around in Philadelphia anymore now, huh?
Yeah, you know, Boxing Commission.
I think Joe Hand is the only guy that's pretty active now. They're going to casinos.
Yeah, Joe, I just talked to him. Great guy. He has a lot coming up, yes.
Yeah. I'd like to have him on my show. You touch base with him.
I will.
Yeah, you know, I can
Joe's
help promote because my show covers a good part of Montgomery County. And so, you're a celebrity. What got you involved in that celebrity boxing? I mean, you got... Yeah, this wasn't under the command of the Boxing Commission, was it?
No, it had nothing.
Sometimes we're a little upset about, though.
Yeah, they got upset because they couldn't touch me. But the bottom line is, I hooked up with the actor Danny Bonaducci, and we started doing celebrity boxing.
The movie actor, right?
Yeah. And Tanya Harding, remember her, the skater?
Oh, yeah.
So
she was one on a box, a celebrity.
Yeah, so I started doing fights with them, Jose Canseco,
and
Rodney
King. The announcer for Channel 10.
Oh yeah, Vi Sikahema fought for me, and John Belaris, the weatherman.
Well, now when you get these celebrities, you get train them a little bit, and who do they fight? They fight. Have somebody lined up for them.
Yeah, it all depends. If I do an event in Hollywood, I match them against each other. It all depends where we're at.
Yeah, you can't put a pro fighter against a celebrity just because he's a celebrity. That's like What's that show where they dance and celebrity dance?
Dancing with the Stars. But see, I'm giving the celebrity with 15 minutes of fame or more their 16th minute. Yeah. So I can't I can't put them in there to get beat.
No. And so now these celebrity boxing bouts, who, how many rounds and how, what's the scoop on that? How do you set that up?
We three do round, five yeah, it's 3 1-minute rounds because we just give them a little chance at stepping in the ring, and that's how we do it. And you know, I've done 65 of them, and you know, I've given all these people with 15 minutes of fame or more, tabloid stars, actors, their 16th minute by stepping in the ring. Now my book came out. Now I'm hoping to get a biopic movie.
Oh yeah, you got a movie coming out.
That's the plan here. Yeah.
Oh yeah. Okay, well then you got the book. We'll talk about the book, but I want to talk a little bit more about you. And what makes you got a question from the balcony? The guy with the brown hat up there. What makes a great boxing match? What makes, regardless of the celebrity, but a box, you know, a boxer and a slugger, two left-handers. What's the story on that?
I think it just it all depends on who the fighters are, and they just, you know, if they get into it and they battle it out, that's real important.
That's a celebrity. You just let them.
Well,
let
celebrity them fights, they go at it anyway, so they have to. It's only 3 1-minute rounds, but
Only 1 minute rounds.
Only 3 1-minute rounds, so they have to battle it out.
And they get tired.
Yeah, they do. I mean, people don't understand. Boxing's no joke in that ring.
You know, I had my grandson Anthony Barano, who's a policeman here in West Norton.
Yeah, he fought.
You said that you need any, you have any celebrities? And what about? Yeah, it's my grandson. So I wanted my grandson to have one fight at least. You know, because I fought in a professional. I wanted him to follow me. So you lined him up.
Yeah.
We fought in Broomall.
Yep. Yeah.
So what happened? The guy he was supposed to fight, my grandson was only 160 pounds. The guy he was supposed to fight didn't show.
Yeah.
So there was a guy there for 200 pounds. So Anthony says, look, 100 people come here to see me fight, and I don't care who I fight.
Yeah, right.
So he went in the ring with the guy, spotted him 40-some pounds, you know. And I says, well, when that bell rings, go out there and just start swinging.
Yeah.
Don't let him get close to you. He knocked him out in 17 seconds.
I know. He was...
And I said, you retire. So now he's a cop. And
He's a really nice guy. He did great.
Yeah, he's good. Yeah. So now you helped me sometime. We had you named the gymnasium after an arena after me up there in Oaks.
Well, they did the Hank Cisco Arena. Plus, you were also inducted to the Celebrity Boxing Hall of Fame. Remember?
Yeah.
I gave you a bunch of awards.
Well, I'm 94. You know, you gotta get something by the time.
You deserve it, man. If there's one guy out there, you deserve it.
So, how do you choose a celebrity? How do you choose? How about women?
Well,
you have women celebrities?
I've had Tanya Harding, Octomom,
the ice skater.
Yeah, Tila Tequila. We've had all kinds of women fight, yes.
Yeah. And so what was your favorite celebrity fight? Who was the most famous and who was anything happened that
I think
they got mad at each other?
We did Danny Bonaducci took on Jose Canseco. You might have been there. And they battled it out. It was a really interesting fight. And
they
went at it.
They really bet it, huh?
Yeah, they went at it. And we called it a draw. It was a close fight.
Oh, how do you choose a celebrity? Do you make a phone call to them? You check them? You get to meet them?
Well, I either reach out to them or their managers contact me because they're looking for business. They're looking for a chance to make a payday and also get their name back out there. That's what I do with my platform. 16
they get paid weekly, very weekly.
Yeah. Well, not for me. We build it and they're building them.
Hey, what was your most famous celebrity bout? Who was the one that caused more action and controversy or something?
Well, Jose Canseco was one, the baseball
player.
What's
he doing? Yeah, Jose.
He fought for me 5 times. He was the steroid guy, but also Rodney King was really interesting. He was a really big draw. And he was big to my legacy with the Celebrity Boxing 16-Minute Man platform.
Now, you did all these things. You're boxing, promoter, the assembly. What inspired you? What inspired you to write this book? Tell us something about this book.
All right.
Why?
So, yeah, well, you know, I was, I hit a brick wall and I was suffering from depression and I didn't know what was happening to me, and I just went into a situation, made a big mistake, and I wrote my book under depression. And it took me 3 weeks. Someone put it together for me, Sporty Smith from Be For Real Entertainment, and now I'm here. So I'm going around.
Well, I'm glad you talk about it, because everybody at some time or other has some kind of depression or so, or you know, like I just had a couple of weeks here. My sister passed away, and I was there all the time, and then until they told me how to pull the plug. You know, but you got to keep going. You know,
hey, there's no doubt about
it. So, how did you work yourself out of it?
Well, I hit a brick wall, man, and I didn't know what I was going through. I was drinking, I was out of control at the time, and you know, I hit a brick wall, and I just wrote the book, and you know, I'm just trying to get over things now, and you know, making a big comeback, and I just want to inspire people and help kids with depression.
Well, this is going to help you, because make you happy.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, what is in the book? What's the book all about now? Tell me something about the book.
Well, it's about my career as a former undefeated professional fighter, growing up in a household where my mom was a quadriplegic in a wheelchair, and my career got ended, so I had to make a comeback. So I stopped undefeated, and I went after my next career in promoting. Did some pro fights. Then I started getting into celebrity boxing because I had my own niche.
All right, now it's called The 16-Minute Man. Now, what's that all about?
Well, I give people with 15 minutes of fame or more their 16th minute. So that's their chance.
What do you mean 15 minutes of the fight?
15 minutes of fame. Like, if they get 15 minutes of fame, I give them their 16th minute.
Oh, okay.
Like, to stay famous and all. And if you want to be famous, I give you your 15 minutes by stepping in the ring.
Yeah.
So, yes.
And then, I know, I went to see a couple of your celebrity fights. Then I took a newspaper reporter, Oscar Gamble.
Stan.
Yeah, and Stan Husky.
Yeah.
Saw the fights, you know. And then tell me, you did a fundraiser for Montgomery Hospital, too. You remember that? We did that over at Valley Forge. Valley Forge Casino,
didn't we give
them?
I think they raised some money for them, right? We did something for them.
Yeah,
remember?
Tell me some of the fundraisers you've helped different organizations.
I have helped it several. You know, a big thing with me was autism, and just, you know, different people needed help. I love helping people.
Yeah.
You know, so
when they come to you to help you, you know.
Yeah.
And I think the most guy that's most active right now is Joe Hand. Tell me something about that.
He's a great guy. Him and his dad, Johan Senior.
Yeah, no,
both.
One was a policeman.
Senior. Yeah, and they have a fight coming up at the Parks Casino coming up.
In the casino.
Yeah.
Where's that at? Over in the
Parks Casino in Bucks County.
Oh, okay.
And I just talked to Joe.
You go there much?
Well, I might be doing a book signing at the fights. What I do is go around the fights.
What's the date on that?
June 29th at Parks Casino.
June 29th.
Yeah.
All right, I think I'll go there. Let me know.
Maybe you should make your return as a referee.
Well, I'll go in and say one round or two.
Hank
you
Sisko,
think the commissioner let me?
Come on, we'll pull some strings.
Well, we're in the casino. Yeah, I'll get in. I did that. I'd had help me get in and out of there.
You did great. You're always
just so
good.
Nobody hits me.
That's
all.
That was good.
So, all right, I know with you refereed ran some fights down along the Delaware River.
Yeah.
What was the name of that place?
It's called the Lagoon Nightclub. I started there.
Nightclub?
Yeah, it was a nightclub, big facility outside. Did several fights there, yes.
Yeah, and would you ever manage anybody?
Never got into managers. I was all about my career in boxing. And just my promoting career. Now I'm about my book and movie.
Oh, yeah? That's what's the movie about?
It's going to be about my life as a former undefeated fighter. Got injured.
Am I going to be in it?
Of course. You could play my dad in it.
Drive with me.
Why don't we get that, man?
I know.
Man,
over here, Rock.
I know. You've been everywhere. Listen, right. I've known you for a long time, since I was a kid.
Well, skim through that and tell me some highlights or something.
Just cool, you know, like Mark Wahlberg's guy fought for us. Mark Wahlberg's the big actor. One of his personalities fought for us. We have Howard Stern's tan mom. She fights.
Howard Stern?
One of his personalities.
Oh, he didn't?
He wouldn't fight.
No.
He told me when I talked to him, he wanted $50 million. Yeah. He said, Rosebud, I said, Howard, how much would it take to get you in the ring when I was on a show? He said, we'll start off with $50
million. Oh, my God.
So I had Amy Fisher, Joey Buttafuoco, Jeremy Jackson, the kid from Baywatch, the TV show.
Baywatch, yeah.
I had UFC guys fight.
Well, once you get contact with these people, it just like blocks one after the other, help you out, right?
Yeah, well, that helps, but I also go after them. They're also, a lot of them are tabloid stars, so I'm able to reach out to them, or they get in touch with me, because I give them their next chance at fame.
Yeah. So, well, Sylvester Stallone's doing a show down in South Philly.
Yeah, we got to get you in that movie.
Huh?
You should be in that movie.
I should. Vince, I was supposed to get down and meet him there, and then I couldn't get nobody to drive me down.
We got to get you. He probably remembers
I had the guy call me, wanted to go on my show. They're doing Creed 2.
Yeah.
I lost his phone number, or I'd have him on, see?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Hook it up sometime so we get down there and we can meet him, you
definitely.
Know?
Definitely. I will.
We'll work something out. And this is one of my last shows until September.
Okay.
June the 7th will be my last show.
Awesome.
For the term. Then I'll start up. And by that time, you'll be able to move something. If you can make a contact with Sylvester, maybe I can get him up here.
Definitely.
I don't know.
Yeah, I can reach out to his brother Frank, who I'm friends with.
Is he still around?
Frank's in Los Angeles, but we're working on something.
You touch base with him?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, we'll get that. I mean, you're my man.
I know that.
I know, man. Goddamn. So, all right. How about the women fighters? When they were going to have I was a referee, and there was the first time they're going to be a women fighter in Philadelphia, and they wanted me to referee, and I said, no, I don't want to referee. I don't know. For some reason or other, I mean, I don't think they should be fighting, but, you know, punching each other, beating each other. And then the other one where they hit them when they went on the floor, the other kind of fight. They should ban that.
You don't like MMA. Mixed martial arts. Yeah, I don't really like it.
No, that's a coward. You hit them when they're down, you kick them. No, come on.
My brother started the new bare knuckle fighting. It starts next week. It's like with John L. Sullivan. He's going to do it on pay-per-view from Wyoming, June 2nd.
Oh, in Wyoming?
Yeah.
There's all them cowboys out there.
The state.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Is it sanctioned by the State Athletic Commission?
Yeah, it's only State Athletic Commission that approved it, yes.
A bear fight, bare hands.
Like John L. Sullivan, yeah.
There no wraps?
They have certain wrapping. I don't know how it goes. It's
no
not
gloves,
my thing,
yeah.
But my brother is his passion, and he made it happen.
Well, you know, I see some of these boxers come in after they take the gloves off, there's all kinds of bandage, you know. Before, you wasn't supposed to have anything across here. When I was in New York boxing, the commission didn't have anything on the knuckles over here.
Yeah.
It was all around here.
How many fights did you have?
I don't know, it was around 15 or so. I don't know, some were down. I went in the Army, then I was down in Atlanta. They didn't have no commission down here. I fought different places, you know.
How many fights did you promote, referee?
Oh my God, a lot. The one I was supposed to go down to South America, Venezuela, the referee, that one guy, what's his name? He comes in the ring with a snake from Cuba.
I'm not familiar with who that is. Rodrigo Valdez? Or?
And the two brothers I can't think of it. And I went down to South America, and I said, I'm going to be a referee. I have Mike Bagley. The guy says, no. You be judge. We got our own referees. You shut up. They take your passport away from you.
Really?
So I'll never go down south to South America referee again. They're mean, you know.
Yeah.
And then I voted for the American. And after that, the promoter come in and start howling in my dressing room. And the other guy was from another South American city. and he voted for the American. He hollered at him and screamed at him. He said, I can see where the American would vote for the American, but not you. You're a coward.
So I figure we're on your show, right? This is your show.
Yeah.
I'm going to negotiate a deal with you right now. What do we have to do to get you to be or your final match in a celebrity boxing match you referee? What do we have to do?
Yeah, well, we can take it.
Talk to your guys.
I'll talk to the director. He gets it.
We got to talk to them.
Yeah.
We'll make it happen.
All right, tell me a little bit more about the book here.
Just real excited, man.
Where can I buy it?
Well, you go to my website, damonfeldman.com, and it's going to be on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, everything in the next 6 months. But right now, I'm just doing a book tour. Bless you.
Go ahead.
Just doing a book tour right now. It's just I go around. I'm doing a lot with the Jewish community because I'm going to get my bar mitzvah. Because when I was 13 years old, I wasn't able to get my bar mitzvah because my mom was a quadriplegic in a wheelchair.
Bless you. I got to sneeze. I don't know what.
Bless you. But I'm real excited about getting my bar mitzvah. And I'm real excited to help people with depression because I went through something
happy. A lot of people, you know, that everybody's come up. And I think that that's a big thing today because there's so many things that people worry about, you know. And a close friend dies or a relation dies, your mother, your father, your uncle, you know, and you lose your job or divorce or something. So people need some kind of something to lean on, something to help, you know.
Well, people that suffer from depression need hobbies. They need to get a hobby. They need to work out. That helps relieve the stress on their brain.
Good workout,
Very, very important.
Yeah,
very
get the blood moving. Definitely. That's good.
Yeah.
All right, now, here's another question from the audience. What does your celebrity training consist of? What do you do?
You get the celebrity on board, you hook them up with a trainer, and then you go step by step, just learn how to throw the punches. I don't train the celebrity. I'll get trainers for them. I'm just a promoter.
I make the events happen. Yeah, you get somebody in the corner.
Yeah.
Yeah, a corner man. Yeah. Was there any two celebrities that boxed and then they got mad at each other and really went at it?
That's a good
question. You had to jump in? No?
It did happen. I had this rapper, Coolio, took on Jeremy Jackson, the kid from Baywatch. And after the event, they got into it in the crowd. And I had Octomom, she took on Amy Fisher, and they got into it afterwards, too. But that's about it. I didn't have to make it. Yeah.
Yeah, well, that was... that's... All right. And what really makes a good bout? Like a slugger and a boxer? You think maybe... I don't like to see where there's... Two boxers are always counterpunting, and then nobody punches. They keep going.
Well, it's about two guys trying to make the action happen. They gotta go at each other and just let the fight go on, battle it out.
But a corner man, how important is a corner man?
I think a corner man is very important because the fighter obviously can't see what he's doing. You could visualize what you have to do differently, being a trainer, how you have to execute your punches, different moves. To overwhelm the opponent or, you know, outsmart them. Everybody thinks boxing is just going to fight. It's a thinking game.
No, just think of,
you have to have brains. There's no doubt.
You know, I know I had Rocky Marciano's trainer, manager, and Charlie Goldman.
Yeah, Goldman.
So I was fighting in New York. That's a club up in Yonkers. And... I went out there and the guy, I'm going after him, going after him, he's running. And so finally I just relaxed, chasing him all over the place. Then all of a sudden, about 15, 20 seconds, he started. So I come back and I says, and my trainer says, Hank, what, this guy's a 50, he's a flash fighter.
Yeah.
He says, he's going to fight the last 15 seconds. So what you do, stay on him. And then when he wants a fight, get away from him. I won the fight very easy.
Yeah, that's awesome.
See, there's little techniques when a trainer in the corner can spot sure, them things, you
definitely.
Know.
Definitely. Different moves,
right,
technical
right,
points.
Right.
So what do we got to do to get you stepping? If you don't do a celebrity referee, want to do a celebrity boxing match, I can put you in with someone.
Oh,
who do you want to fight?
I'm referee, but I got to do no boxing. Where's that big boxing glove? You know.
I like that one.
I mean, if you can get if you can get somebody that's a patient at Montgomery Hospital, or I mean Einstein, and then have him out and ready for the fight, I'll take him on.
So, all right.
Yeah.
All right.
Now I had some referee, and I remember one guy. You know, they're all excited before you're in the dressing room and you're waiting for the be called the next fight. You know, and you relax. You don't put your trunks on or anything. You know, you just relax yourself. And finally, boom, I'm in the center of the ring. Look, wait, over there. This guy takes his robe off. All he had on was a jock strap. He forgot to put his
really?
Things on. He's
going
out. So, but there was a lot of good bouts. I refereed in the Spectrum. Refereed.
I remember, yeah.
And so, your book, tell me about this one page. I'm going to open it up here. And I see here, a guy slugging it out.
Well, that's Jose Canseco. So yeah. I did a fight in Florida, and when I got to the weigh-in, his twin showed up instead. He sent his twin instead. And it just was bizarre. And the media went crazy. And then it talks about me. Remember, you know, Cameron Diaz is, right?
Oh, yeah.
I got into it a little. She's funny.
Yeah.
Diaz, Mayweather's uncle. There's Rodney King right there. That's Rodney King.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's my dad.
How about boxing? How has boxing changed over your career? It's changed. A lot different.
The state athletic commissioners, I think, boxing's not like base. Everybody involved in other sports have actually played the sports. Everybody running boxing, the commissioners, they've never been in the ring. They can't really understand.
No, it's political.
You have to build the fighter up.
Yeah.
And that's
the
problem with the athletic commissioners.
Yeah. And I know, I remember some of, what was it, Widener? He never fought. He didn't know anything about boxing. He's a commissioner. I got about four or five, you know. So that causes a problem.
Oh, it definitely does, yeah.
It causes a problem, you know. And then another thing with the referee, you got to get a license to be a boxer. Referee, I think it's $35 or so, and I have to get them kind of tests and all. But it's just
not organized right. The commission, how they do it here in Pennsylvania, they just go to the events. They don't check everything. They got to give people chances.
Right, right.
They have to have the right people. This athletic guy is not doing the right job.
Right. All right, ladies and gentlemen, 30 minutes is up, but here it is. Damon Feldman, the 15-minute man.
16.
15 minutes?
16.
So six, I thought it was 15.
I'm going to give you your 16.
Where's my glass? Give me your glasses there. That's 16. Why 16?
Because I've given people with 15 minutes of fame or more their 16th minute by stepping in the ring. Celebrities.
Okay. Well, we did a lot of things together.
I know.
And I'll try to make it at the... What, the 29th, you say?
That's Parks Casino. That's not my event. That's Johan's event.
Johan. I met him years ago when Frank Gelb was running
Frank Gelb, sure.
Yeah, so... But, all right, so... I wish you luck.
Yeah,
and
you
then,
too.
Where can I get this book?
My website, DamonFeldman.com. It's going to be on Amazon, you know, everything in a little while.
Okay, so... Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for allowing us to come into your house, the kitchen, front room, patio, on the beach, and this is what you got to do. Left hand high, stick and move, and keep your trunks off the canvas, okay? So until we meet again, shake hands
there. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
And adios, amigos. Pow! Alonzo Lou, Rock. That means to your health. You got your health, you can beat them all up.
Thank you, yeah.